So, I watched the three Divergent movies that are out so far, and my opinion of them is predictably bad. The premise alone makes no sense, since it assumes people live in harmony when they are only allowed to do one thing, and any divergence is considered anarchy, punished by death. Plus, the whole thing is excused with genetics and not personal choice. You are born to think in a specific way. If you are not, you are an abomination that needs to be exterminated. Predictably, the heroine is one such individual, not because she chose to think outside the box, but because she was born special. Boring. Most of the first movie is about watching her doing parkour training, which is pretty dull, but at least gives an excuse to make her move around and see what the other factions are doing. Up to its third quarter, it's a basic dystopian slice of life. The last quarter is when whatever logic this movie tried to have goes to hell. It all comes down to evil faction A wanting to kill good faction B so it can rule supreme. For that purpose, it brainwashes police faction C and sends it to kill faction B. If they have brainwashing technology, why don't they simply brainwash faction A and be done with it? Not only that, but the main villain does the usual bullshit thing where she arrests everyone before ordering their execution, something that makes no sense and only wastes a lot of time. She also doesn't simply kill the heroine for being a divergent who wants to stop her, but instead spends half an hour explaining her evil master plan, which again makes no sense and wastes a lot of time. As expected, the heroine finds enough time to break free, magically undo the brainwashing of her boyfriend with the power of love, and brainwashes the villain into stopping the execution. Fucking lazy resolution. It only gets worse in the second movie, where nothing makes sense anymore. The villains are chasing the heroine and are unable to capture her even when she's on foot and they use cars. They can't even hit her with machine guns when she is simply running out in the open. So she tries to escape on a train. She doesn't get on the train as it passes by, she runs to the other side of the tracks so she can use the wagons as cover and then get on. This makes no sense, since closing the door of a wagon is more than enough to protect her from bullets. She didn't have to go to the other side for that, and it's not like the villains knew how to use a damn gun. On the train, she conveniently finds rebels who don't like her and immediately attack. They fight for about 15 minutes where a dozen people are brutally killed or crippled, and then her boyfriend remembers to tell them he's the son of their leader, so they stop. This battle was pointless! In the meantime, the villain finds this magic box that contains a message from the founders of this stupid faction system. The thing is, it can only be opened by a pure divergent. So she orders the heroine to be captured alive and brought to her so she can open it. Well then, thank goodness nobody knew how to shoot straight all this time, or the heroine would be dead and the box would never be opened. This, by the way, is another thing that makes no sense. If her plan was to eradicate the divergents and control the city, why does she want to read a message that needs the very thing she is trying to eradicate? It goes against her master plan. Not only that, but being a divergent just changed from being an abomination to being very important, a thing that contradicts everything the first movie was about. The heroine eventually surrenders to the bad guys after they threaten to kill innocent people until she does. Such well-written bad guys, you really see they have a good reason for wanting to take over the world. So the heroine opens the box and finds out that not only the divergents are the special ones, not only everybody else is a genetic mistake, but also she is the best of all divergents, meaning that all this time she was the messiah instead of a mistake. Fucking horseshit. And then out of nowhere, the rebels attack the evil base and save the day. Just like that. Why didn't they do it all this time if it was that simple? The story is retarded. This brings us to the third movie, where the heroine finds the Bureau of Genetic Modification, who are the masterminds behind all this bullshit. They tell her that she is the most genetically perfect human being, so the target audience can also feel special for watching this bullshit. For some nonsensical reason, the Bureau assumes that maintaining the factions is enough to produce divergents, which are genetically fixed. Something that makes no fucking sense, since the best way to have more divergents is to have children born from divergents instead of allowing genetically inferior people to be killing the divergents for centuries. This plan makes no sense, and yet the Bureau decides that now that the truth is out, they must make everybody lose their memories and start from scratch. What kind of logic is this? Oh, and if you think the brainwashing bullshit was too much, get ready to facepalm with the amnesia gas. I'm not kidding you, there is amnesia gas, which will make everybody forget everything and go back to killing the very divergents that are supposed to be genetically superior. What is this bullshit? Anyways, as expected, Jesus Chan saves the day for the third time, because of course she does, she's Jesus with boobs, and organizes the population against the Bureau. Something that will happen in the next movie, which I don't fucking care about, because it's all one big pile of horseshit for brainless teenagers. To hell with this shit!